Hello and welcome, guys and gals, to Ashes Bashes Gaming, your destination for discovering new and exciting games. Today on your screens, we have Sanabi the Revenant. Now, this is part 2 of the demo walkthrough. You can check out part 1 by clicking on the link in the top right corner of your screen. I recommend checking it out as it would give you the premise of the events in this video. Our chopper was just shot down and we are now making our way into Mago City. For those of you who have just joined in, the grey walls are surfaces you can attach your grapple hook to, while there are brown potions which you cannot. Also, there are laser surfaces which would fry you if you came in contact. This is a beautiful pixel art side-scroller game where you point and shoot with your grapple hook and move around with the WASD keys. The music is also pretty techno and gives an appropriate vibe for the dystopian cyberpunk settings of the game. Now, I know I make this look too easy, but it wasn't actually. I took multiple tries to get this right. The maneuvering mechanism of swinging from the grapple hook to move around and avoid getting fried actually took some time to get used to, and I'm not really sure whether I would advise it for people who have motion sickness. Sometimes the movements are pretty fast and you can hardly follow. Now, if you notice, there are a few times you would observe a cut. Those are basically checkpoints and mark the places where I had respawned. Thankfully for me, you will not get to know how many times I had respawned, but the only good thing is that there are multiple checkpoints, and frankly I don't know how I would have completed this video without those. Wait, where do we go now? Is this a dead end? Okay, so this area closed up now. I do not know Japanese, so I don't know what this is. Any Japanese speakers in my YouTube list can probably tell me. Welcome, this is the city of technology and happiness, Mago City. Before entering, we will perform a body scan. It is mandatory security procedure as per the Mago Act, and we greatly appreciate your cooperation. Checking body output. Checking reinforced body. Body output in violation. Unregistered reinforced body. Standard body modification acts included. A total of 676 violations detected. You are subject to an additional inspection. Additional inspection category, autopsy. Oh, you have to kill me. In accordance to the Mago Government Act, autopsy procedures are to be handled under expert supervision. Oh, really? You fools think you can kill me? Really? Oh, okay, there is a turret there too. Please relax and calmly comply with your execution. Wow, though, thankfully. Who else is coming? Okay, I spot a few more. So I took a hit there, and basically you get 3 hit health points, which are reduced by 1 every time you get shot or fried. And once you are done, you have to respawn from the nearest checkpoint. So much for your inspection. The people who are about to make the autopsy have got autopsied. I mean, I know the grammar is all wrong in that, but yeah, okay. So we have entered the city and it is as desolate as promised. Though I do like the neon lights and the backdrop. I mean, these guys have really done a good work for the artwork. You know, it just goes to show the number of hours people put into a game. And at the end of the day, these beautiful games, if hardly people know about it, I think that's the biggest sin there is. That's the biggest loss to humanity, that you know, people put so much of heart, soul and work into making a game really beautiful, and there are so many people involved, so many artists, so many VFX designers, so many story writers, so many things, and at the end of the day we hardly discover it just because they don't have huge budgets and can compete for you know, marketing against big firms or big companies. That, my friends, that's the real injustice. Now, this is a pixelated game, but imagine how good they still managed to, you know, make it look. I mean, I think the biggest magic that they have pulled off is that they have used a very retro style to depict a very dystopian futuristic setting, and that's irony and genius right there. I really enjoyed the kind of artwork as well as the modeling for these enemies. Look at the detail on the different turrets, their fire rates, the different enemies, and even the different enemies have different weapons. And you know, it actually takes a little skill to get used to all the swinging and fighting, because if you notice, when I point and click on an enemy, even where my cursor is placed after the attack makes a difference, because that's the direction I will be jumping off to. Like after you make an attack, you jump off to wherever your cursor is placed. So if you are not mindful of that, I mean, there have been instances where I have, after killing somebody or, you know, destroying somebody, I have moved into a laser field and got myself fried. So these are small details that, you know, take a little getting used to. Now I have to say that I found the turrets to be the most irritating enemy, because, you know, it's very difficult to dodge their sprays, and they actually follow you. So even if you're moving and you're not paying attention, or you are midway in the swing, they will get at you. You know, then there are these huge mechanical robots with a strong shield who lob explosives at you. Now somehow these explosives are also homing missiles. I mean, that's some amazing tech right there. But okay, now the good part is that you can destroy the explosives by similarly left clicking on them and, you know, grappling onto them and hitting them. So we are finally confronting this drone who has been following us for quite some time now. Who are you? Why are you following me? Not talking to you, tin can. Let your owner speak. Wait. Don't do that. Alright, I'm here. Don't break it. Mister, are you human? So you're Marie. How do you know my name? Here to save you. Where are you now? You're here to save me? Mister, you are a soldier? Yeah. And it's just you? Yeah. Save the questions and tell me where you are. Tell me how much you know. Emergency Investigations Team 1 Engineer Marie, Civilian Code M925049, sent to investigate the mass disappearance cause that occurred in Margo. No time enough with questions. Boohoo! Are you crying? Why? You guys promised to provide personal safety. I told you I wasn't going. You dragged me into this. They sent one guy to save me. If you were planning to throw me out in a ghost city, you should have just executed me. This is why there's no patriotism left in me. Calm down. I'm here to provide personal safety. You said you came alone. What can you even do by yourself, mister? Even a whole army might not be able to save me. Do you know what's prowling under your feet, mister? Or where I am right now, mister? Where are you? Where you are? Mister, you said you were here to save me, right? So you should keep that promise, please. Location, now! I am at... Answer me, Marie! Damn it! So we have her bot with us now, but the silly girl didn't tell us her location, so we're just having to search her out. Now thankfully for us, this game has only one direction to go to, and I'm sure it will lead us to her. So that bot is definitely following me around like a faithful puppy. Does it help or does it do anything? I mean, that would be really cool if that bot had some additional functionality. Okay, another fun fact is these shield robots have to be taken out from the back, and if you approach them from the front or hit against the shield, that also takes away a hit point. Though I don't understand the logic behind that. Damn, imagine swinging around on that one arm all day. I think that's really going to take a toll on his hand, right? I mean, his right hand must hurt. Oh wait, actually no, so since that's a mechanical arm, I'm sure there's no feelings for him. But I mean, I think it would be really cool, if they include some of the backstory as to how exactly he got that mechanical arm. They have given us some sneak peek to us that, that he was a brigadier general with the army, and he's a very high ranking officer, and his prodigies themselves or his subordinates themselves have now reached very high positions and they all respect him. But some information as to how he got that mechanical arm, I'm sure that would be a interesting story in itself. I really appreciate the fact that they have made all enemies just one hit to defeat, because it would have become very difficult if there was a grind involved where you have to judge the rhythm of every enemy's attacks and find the off spots and keep hitting at them. That would have been really difficult, because with all this maneuvering around, it's really fast paced. But it has a different charm of its own. Even if there are just three or four enemies on screen, you go around in like super fast speed and literally mess up everything for them. It's impossible for these guys to even aim at me. There are a few lucky times where they get a shot off, but those are really mostly due to my mistakes. Okay, I spot another dead end. Where do we go now? I hate jumping down such narrow passages. You never know what's down there. This looks difficult, and yes, we are fried. As I mentioned earlier, you have to be very mindful about where your cursor is after you make an attack, because that's where you will be flying off to or bouncing off to, whatever. And it's very difficult in tight spaces like this where the walls are lined with lasers and you can get easily fried. So it does take some getting used to, and you will get the hang of it as you progress. The combat mechanics are actually pretty dope once you get used to it. I mean, just look at the trail of destruction you can weave, and in such a short span of time. It's very satisfying to watch and play, to be honest. Marie, I think I spot you. Okay, I guess she was dressed up as something, that was like a fake head over there to make her look larger. I'm sorry, I promise to be good, I swear I'll never do anything ever again, anything bad ever again. Marie? Who are you? I told you I'd come save you. Mr. Soldier? Mister, are you really human? Why do you even mean by that? What do you even mean by that? Did you hurt your head or something? No! You try being stuck in this garbage city for a whole day. I've been stuck here with these crazy robots that keep trying to kill me. Moopin! Okay, that's her bot. Moopin, you okay? Anything damaged? Did you bring Moopin, mister? Its name is Moopin. Just started following me. Anyway, Murray, we don't have time to waste. No time for jokes. Jokes? Do I look like I'm joking? I was on the brink of death so many times. Mister, how did you get here anyway? It is surrounded by murder bots. Don't worry. Took care of that. You what? What? I mean, how? You didn't destroy them, did you? Please tell me you didn't. I did. Every one of them. Oh, so screwed. There is a problem? A problem? Yes, a ton actually. So many. Oh, because of the tin cans? No, never mind. In this place, underneath the floor, it's coming! Okay, that's like a mechanical worm or something. Well, she's flown away to safety. Why are you just standing there? Run! Okay, this has got to be one of the favorite bosses I've encountered in any game. I mean, this is so unique, man. It's a damn mechanical worm, and look at the speed at which it is, spawning at different locations from the ground. I really loved the imagination of the game devs. I have to say, this game seems like a real work piece of art, man. And if this is the kind of effort they've put into it, then it's amazing. Damn, I mean, this was really difficult to dodge and actually make my way out of. Murray, you really ran without waiting for me. So to summarize what you said, a little higher. Muppin is not a lamp. Anyway, to summarize what you just said, you came to the city without knowing anything, right? How is that a summary? I mostly got the deets down. There was a network blackout in the city and all the people disappeared at the same time. Anything other than that? Nope. You know nothing! The people disappeared! Not just 300, all 3 million of them. And everything within Poop City, and I mean everything, is trying to kill us. The fools are busted, zapping 20,000 volt short circuit the floors. And underneath the damaged ground is an 800 ton steel worm just roaming around. How the hell are you so calm? Oh, that's my secret. Kiddo, I'm a soldier. I'm here to handle the problem. And getting emotional does nothing to help solve it. Really? I understand what you're worried about, but I assure you there's no need for concern. You give me the info, I'll handle the problem. The info? Yes, the info. What your team found out. Oh. About that, truth is, damn, I'll just come out with it. There is none. What do you mean none? No info? Didn't you say through the emergency signal that you had some info? If I hadn't said that, I knew no one would come. You guys made a huge mistake from the start. A mistake? What do you mean? How do I explain this? Okay, so there was a network blackout. That doesn't simply mean that the channels connected outside of the city were closed. That was merely the result. Explain. The city, so the Mago group uses a standalone communications protocol. Stop, I asked you to explain it. I wasn't asking you to explain it like that. Then how? I'm not an engineer, just get to the point. All data in the city disappeared. There is no data left. It's basically no use sending investigation teams. There's nothing left to investigate. There's no data left. None. Wiped clean. This Sanabi guy is quite the character. Not good. Alright, Murray. You will now get out of the city. What? If what you say is true, there is no need for you here. It's just too dangerous for you.
But I mean, what about you? What's the plan? Gotta figure that out starting now. Mister, you said you're here to handle the problem.
Yeah.
So, how much trust can I put in you?
You asking me?
Trust me however much you want.
Just one thing, there is one way.
Do tell.
You won't like it.
Up, do you like fishing?
Oh, okay. So we're gonna use the crane to lure the worm.
Ah, this is the demo version. Thank you for playing. So guys, I had a blast playing this, and if you guys liked what you all saw, I'll leave the link to the Steam page in the description below. And if you enjoyed this video, then smash that like button and consider subscribing to my channel so that you can discover new and exciting games daily. This is Ashes Bashes signing off. Until next video, game on!